The big number, I think, staring all of us is whether the Nifty will touch 11,000, just a shade below that. I think the focus clearly is on that. And this is the third post-budget rally, if I could call it that, in the Modi era. 2016, 2017, we had seen that. But we have with us Niranjan Hiranandani, even as the Nifty is testing the day's high. And Mr. Hiranandani, landmark announcements for the sector, notional rent exemption for the second house, and there are other announcements including the rollover of capital gain for the investment in the second residential house. How good is this for your sector?
I think it's a wonderful thing that the focus has been on housing. I think it's an exceptional year where I think housing has taken a full focus. First of all, the most important statement, which does not really stand out but is very important, is GST. They have mentioned that it's referred to a group of ministry, and it's looking like that the 12% GST will come down to 5 or 7 or 8. So that's going to be a next big relief. The other aspects of it also indicated that the affordable housing tax-free status has been shifted to 2020, extension of 1 year. I think that was necessary because construction of houses have started, but the benefit of it would not go to the developers unless this date was extended. So I think that's a good thing. So the focus on affordable housing continues. I think standard deduction overall to all the people has really become extremely important for the purposes of this. And I think the focus has been to say that housing for all should actually be achieved. I think that's the direction we've done. Second, I found something which was extraordinary. He reduced the benchmark for income tax, which is 5 lakhs, and reduced the taxation from 2.5% to 0. I think that was a big thing. So all these takeaways and the expenditure which has taken place, remember, I was expecting that there would be some tax on the higher side and still have a very balanced budget with a net position of not having an additional deficit. I think balancing this budget in a political year with give to each of the sectors, whether it is housing, whether it is to farmers, whether it is middle class, whether it is to SMMEs or direct transfers, all these things put together required a lot of money, including the army. So I think what has happened is the miracle has happened, that you've been able to give so many people so many things and have not charged a single rupee of additional tax and still kept the fiscal deficit into order. The combination is fantastic, unbelievable. Probably the best budget in the Modi era in the last 4 years has been this budget. You may call it political, you may call it election budget, but actually I think it's a fantastic budget.
Absolutely, Mr. Hiranandani, we are calling it nothing such. We've always maintained that this was going to be a full budget. The markets recognizing this came a little late in the day, could have happened a year before. The Nifty futures, meanwhile, ladies and gentlemen, have crossed 11,000. We will continue that focus. We also have another tax expert, Rajiv Memani, who is with my colleague Fatima Mahdi, and she's having a discussion with him. But I will go to that after one more point that I want to focus on, and this is as far as the markets are concerned, because very clearly nothing has been done which is negative in any manner. But the forward-looking vision that has been provided, including the aim to take India into... we have Mr. Deepak Parekh here with us. Mr. Parekh, welcome to BTVI. Clearly, major announcements as far as the housing sector is concerned, the exemption of notional rent on the second house, as well as affordable housing extended by a year. Your first reaction, sir?
No, it's a very practical budget so far as real estate is concerned. Real estate is having a difficult phase, and developers are unable to sell the product, sell the flats within 1 year of construction. And there's finding a notional rent on unsold inventory adds to the burden of developers' abilities. And it's a very practical move by the finance minister to